before and during her reign, Her Majesty has made many broadcasts to the nation and the wider Commonwealth, giving an insight into the philosophy and leadership qualities that has made her into the iconic, selfless and inspirational leader we know today. Her Majesty made her first radio broadcast in 1940, when at the age of 14, she recorded a message of support for all the young people affected by the war. On her 21st birthday, in a speech broadcast on the radio from Cape Town in South Africa, the Queen, then Princess Elizabeth, dedicated her life to the service of the Commonwealth when she said, "I declare before you all that my whole life, whether it be long or short, shall be devoted to your service." On the evening of her coronation, through a radio broadcast, she stated, "Throughout all my life and with all my heart, I shall strive to be worthy of your trust." Now, 70 years later, her grandson, Prince William, the Duke of Cambridge, declares how true she has been to her words when he says, "I think I speak for my generation when I say that the example and continuity provided by the Queen is not only very rare among leaders, but a great source of pride and reassurance." Her Majesty has had an extraordinary life and reign. From a young girl who did not expect to be queen, to an iconic and celebrated figure who has ruled for 70 years. Still, in the difficult days of 2022, Her Majesty inspires us when in her Commonwealth Day message this year she said, "In these testing times, it is my hope that you can draw strength and inspiration from what we share as we work together towards a healthy, sustainable, and prosperous future for all."
Thank you. both forty, arts, and culture, and many for the preservation of wildlife and the environment. Having Her Majesty as Royal Patron or Resident provides vital publicity for the work of these organisations and allows their enormous achievements and contributions to society to be recognised. At the Patron's Lunch on the Mall this year, Prince William, Duke of Cambridge, in his speech said, "We are here to celebrate the Queen as Patron. Her commitment to the more than 600 charities to which she lends her name and support is unwavering." In return, the Queen replied, "I pay tribute to the commitment, selfless devotion, and generosity of spirit shown by the hundreds of charities and voluntary organisations represented here today." The Queen sees public and voluntary service as one of the most important elements of her work. The Queen has lived as Royal Patron or President with over 600 charities, military associations, professional bodies, and public service organisations. These vary from well-established international charities to smaller bodies working in a specialist area or on a local basis only. Her Majesty supports and encourages achievement in all walks of life through the annual program of investitures at which she presents members of the general public with their honours. Garden parties, receptions, and other awards given in her name, which allow her to say thank you to all those who have contributed to the life of the nation and the Commonwealth.
Thank you. of Her Majesty would have been one time when the Queen was unable to laugh out loud. And she would have had to keep her face straight when Prince Philip, looking at the crown, whispered to her on the day, "Where did you get that hat?" More recently, the Queen was inspecting the guard at Buckingham Palace. And as she walked past one of the soldiers, she was aware that
corgis since her 18th birthday in 1944, when she received her first corgi, Susan, as a birthday gift. Her other corgis have all been descended from Susan. Her Majesty's first corgi, a shepherd called Peggy, was a gift from her grandfather, King George V. Probably her most famous horse, a black mare called Bernice, was presented to her by the Royal Canadian Mounted Police in 1969. She rode Bernice side saddle in Trooping the Colour every year until 1986, when Her Majesty decided that from 1987 onwards, she would ride in a carriage and review the troops from a dais. Bernice was then retired to enjoy the pasture at Windsor. In 2005, the Queen unveiled a bronze statue in Saskatchewan of herself riding Bernice. The statue is situated where Bernice was born and trained. The Queen today has many horses. She still rides and she loves to watch her beloved animals at the races.
Thank you. Jubilee.